I'ma be 100 with you. It ain't looking too good for Kodak Black.
Can't stop this money marathon, but they gon' try regardless. When you go, it's harder.
So look, Kodak Black, he had a plan when he went to court this time. If y'all know, he up in jail for violating his probation by kicking it with Adrian Bronner, going to strip clubs, and doing the most, just doing too much. While he was at the strip club, I guess he supposedly put his hands on some female up in there. So Kodak like, man, I ain't touch her. She just saying that so she can get some money. She's saying that so she can put me in jail and some more stuff. So when he went to court, he had everybody that worked at the club in the courtroom. You had the bouncer in there. You had the manager in there, the owner in there, some of the females that work in there, the bartender in there. Like, they really testifying like, look, Kodak Black, he came in there just to have fun. He didn't touch nobody. He didn't hurt nobody. We don't know what she's talking about. And so the judge like, look, hold on. The DA's like, look, did he pay y'all to come in here? How did all y'all come in here at once on his behalf and none of y'all saying nothing bad? So they like, no, Your Honor, we didn't pay, no, sir, we didn't pay nothing. Everybody know, like, yeah, you slid them something so they can come up in there on your behalf, which I would have did too. I'm trying to get out. And I just got out. Now you back in there 2 or 3 months, man, I'm trying to get out. So they testify, say what they gotta say. The DA present his case. Like, look, judge, don't worry about what they saying. Me and you already talked on lunch. We already agreed that we gonna go ahead and lock him up, play a little golf, and just go ahead and move this case to the side. There's another one under our belt, sir. Yeah. Man, we know how y'all get down. So a little time go by, Kodak Black got his family in there. He got a finger crossed. His lawyers got the finger crossed. They like, yeah, bro, I know you brought them all in here on your behalf, but you still guilty. On all counts. So when he said that, Kodak mama start tripping, like crying, running out the courtroom, going outside, sitting on the steps crying, like, no lie, these are the reports. And I already know she crying because she know the money is gone. And I know Kodak Black, when they told him that he guilty, and he went back to that cell, I know he like, man, I pay all them people that money to come up here and lie for me, and they still found me guilty. Why you up in there, you losing money, and you just paid all that money for them people to come up in there and lie for you? Now you just feeling sick. And I know everybody like, when he going to jail, like, why he keep going back to court, like, look, he got one more court date, it's May 4th, all right? May 4th, he going up in there, they gonna see if he get back on probation, or he gonna get the 6 to 8 years, whichever one. He either gonna get back on probation and be free, or he gonna get the 6 to 8 years and go ahead and lock it up and throw your career down the toilet with it, cause it's a wrap. And then he gonna really be up in there sick, like, dang, I should've just listened, or man, I should've, yeah. Even though you 19, bro, even though you make mistakes, it's just something that you just can't keep on repeatedly doing over and over. And the judge, no matter who you is, like I keep telling you, what you do, your profession, your... Bro, you a repeat offender. It's a rap. And that's how they look at it. DJ Ghost 100.